were actually referred to Coastal by some friends who had been to Schnorr before. And I just felt totally comfortable. I felt like a weight had been lifted when we met him, and he was just very down to earth and honest. And we didn't really visit anywhere else. That's all I needed. Yeah. Everyone knows I love me some Schnorr.
You don't know it again until you actually have success. And God willing, we hope everybody has success, you know, at Coastal, because it's worth the wait. The pain just goes away after you...
It does. It just melts away.
It just melts away after you get your blessing. So just hang in there, wait it out. It's worth the wait, because you end up getting, not on your timeline, so to speak, but you get what you want.
It'll make more sense later.
And it makes
later.
More sense when they're here.
Received the phone call that we were pregnant. I was so excited. And I remember telling my husband and then calling my family, just letting them know that, you know, hey, we're pregnant. And I know usually people wait, but we didn't do that. We called family immediately. We were just so excited. After waiting for so many years, it was just very exciting. The advice that I would give to anyone would be not to wait. If you're having trouble within like the first 6 months to a year, I would go see someone, and it's just worth having someone that specializes to see you and help you out to see what will actually work for you, and just to definitely just take it one day at a time, because it's a process and it's a journey. So my advice would just be to take it as it goes and just have as much peace as you can with the process.
I tried for about a year on our own, and took us about a year, did 3 IUIs, 1 round of IVF, 2 embryos, and got 3 babies.
Wow.
So I was sick from day one. So that 2-week wait, I was sick the entire 2 weeks. So I had a feeling that we were pregnant, and my HCG numbers were through the roof. And so when we came in for the first ultrasound, we knew there were 2 at least, and we couldn't tell in the second sac whether there was a 3rd. So the next ultrasound, when we came back, there were clearly 3 in there. So we had a little bit of time to warm up to the fact that there were possibly 3, but when it was reality, I think you're just kind of like, okay, this is happening. I think Dr. Cook probably turned a little more shades of white than we did when it happened. So
you got the best of both.
We did.
All at once. So
yes.
Are you finished?
Yes. Oh, we're done. Yes, absolutely done.
She was about to give up, and I kept pushing. I said, I want to do everything within our possible power and financial means possible to make sure that we could or could not to get to that end. So it took a lot of struggles and a roller coaster ride of happy days and bad days and this, that, and other, but we ended up ultimately very, very happy. It was a wonderful, wonderful son. Couldn't ask for any better. I didn't believe it.
It was at 5:30 in the morning. I came out of the bathroom crying. I was shaking, crying, and laughing all at the same time. And I was like, hun, read this. Because I was so tired of buying pregnancy tests and reading it. And
You took two, I think.
I did, but I got the expensive ones that actually said pregnant or not pregnant.
That read it out.
I said, read this. Tell me what it says. He said, hun, I don't think there's any other way you can read this.
I think it said you're pregnant for like 3 weeks. It never died.
The test.
It kept staying on there.
We couldn't have had a better nurse and a better doctor. They treated us like family. Every time I went in there and cried to Cherub about wanting to give up, she just said, just wait one more time, one more visit. You know, it's gonna get better, and it did. There were lots of hugs and lots of tears. But I never felt, I think one of my fears was that I was gonna feel like less of a person because I had to go through this, less of a woman because I couldn't do things on my own the way God intended. I was never made to feel inferior or like it's your fault. Cause I felt like that before we started going through treatments. I felt like it's all my fault because there wasn't really anything wrong with him. I mean, he'd been tested twice. It was me, it was my body.
Trying for about 3 years. We did everything that people usually will tell you to do, take a vacation, take a break, this and that, and until we decided to take the next step, and my OBGYN recommended to go to Coastal Fertility Specialists, and it has been so far a great, incredible experience. We were fortunate to, we were very lucky to have just a short treatment, and the first IUI, boom, I think we were the easiest patient. That's what Dr. Cook always tells us. You are the easiest patient for the clinic, but very fortunate. I was at home and I took the pregnancy test, and it was positive. My husband was still asleep and I went to wake him up and I'm like, is this a positive? and yeah, it was. And then all the levels were going up and up and up, and yeah, it was great.
How did that make you feel?
Oh, unbelievable. That was the happiest day ever. Mm-hmm. Oh my God. I had a C-section. He was born at 6:57 in the morning, the day after Christmas. And when Dr. Vu lift him and show him next to me, everything stopped. There was no words, no thinking, no nothing. Everything absolutely stopped. Yes, it was incredible.